Today we remember St. Albert the Great, bishop and doctor, who actually was a teacher of another very well-known saint, St. Thomas Aquinas, right?
You know, it's fascinating too, Monsignor. Shouldn't it be our goal as Catholics that when we mentor someone, whether it's a fellow priest, whether it's someone in our firm, someone in a business, someone in the field of education, when we mentor them, shouldn't our goal be in humility that they should surpass our own contributions? Isn't that what happened with St. Albert, that his great store of Catholic philosophy and theology and his being a Renaissance person who was a big figure in biology and is an icon of a Catholic approach to science and the progress of ethical science, that his mentoring of St. Thomas Aquinas prepared Aquinas to be one of the pivotal figures of all the ensuing centuries in terms of his Summa Theologica. So we think about that mentoring today as we celebrate the feast of St. Albert the Great. It's a good time for us to step back and say, give thanks for the people who've mentored us well in life,
sure,
to pray for them, but also to kind of take stock. We're in the people we mentor and have mentored, to pray for them and to have that humility and that great personal strength to wish the best for them, and hopefully that they could surpass the mentoring we've done and go to new horizons of Catholic evangelization and witness.
St. Albert the Great.
Pray for us.